Hello everyone, I'm Carthew, and today we'll be discussing Ultra Instinct. I've known for quite some time that there has been a lot of confusion surrounding it as people try to grapple with the idea of whether or not it is a form, or a technique, or something more. I'll explain to you everything about Ultra Instinct that we know to show you both positions for why people believe it's a form or a technique, and I'll end with my theory of why Ultra Instinct is so different for Goku than it is for Whis or even Beerus in the manga. Without further ado though, let's jump into it. Let's start with the evidence for it being a technique. To start, there's the name, and I don't mean Ultra Instinct as that's a poor translation of the Japanese name. Let's actually take a look at Migatte no Gokui. The Japanese name, when taken literally and in context, means the secret of self-movement. Gokui is the portion that means secret and is usually used to refer to a technique, an art form, or a teaching. So, when the name of the thing is the secret technique of self-movement, that's a pretty beneficial piece of evidence. Further than that, we have the way Ultra Instinct is generally described, especially in the case of Whis's initial description of it during the Resurrection of F-Arc. You see, when Whis takes Goku and Vegeta on as his students, after the Battle of Gods arc that is, and after they have sufficiently grown, they both spar with him at the same time. It's immediately evident though that the two of them can't even land a hit on Whis, and he tells them why. They lack speed. The minuscule amount of speed lost when thoughts have to travel through the nervous system is so great at this point in the series that having a body that can react to and avoid danger on its own is infinitely faster by comparison. The phrasing here is key, as Whis tells the two Saiyans, "You need to teach every part of your bodies to respond on their own." This isn't language typically used when teaching or unlocking a transformation, and the basic principle of ingraining something into yourself is usually attributed to techniques rather than transformations. Now, if we go over to the manga, we get a lot of supplemental evidence in the form of characters flat out calling Ultra Instinct a technique. However, that's not the only thing they call it, but we can refer to that a bit more later on. Finally, you can add in this idea of mastery that comes with Ultra Instinct and is especially discussed when Goku uses Ultra Instinct Omen multiple times. But you can also master a transformation, so that's not a big piece of evidence for one side or the other, like some pretend it is. I think this has pretty comprehensively covered the evidence for it being a technique, so let's discuss Ultra Instinct as a transformation. When Ultra Instinct is revealed in episode 110, we only see an incomplete version of it, this being known as Ultra Instinct Omen. However, despite it being simply an omen of what would come, Ultra Instinct Omen clearly boosts Goku's power as stated by numerous characters who notice that he has overcome the power gap between him and Jiren in an instant. Each subsequent appearance of Ultra Instinct Omen is even stronger than the last as well. This obviously plays into the idea that Ultra Instinct is a transformation, as Kaioken is the only technique known for multiplying one's power, and Whis's description of Ultra Instinct doesn't ever include or imply a growth in power, simply improved speed and reaction time. To further back up that Ultra Instinct is a power-up, we have this interview with the production staff of Dragon Ball Super, who refer to Toriyama calling Ultra Instinct a power-up, but different than Super Saiyan. We'll refer more to this interview a bit later on. On to our next point, in episodes 110 and 116, Ultra Instinct is referred to as a state. This verbiage has led many to speculate that Ultra Instinct is neither a form nor a technique, rather it is something entirely new, a state of being. In this opinion, there is this weird claim that Ultra Instinct being called a state is somehow different from what Super Saiyan is usually referred to in the series in terms of phrasing. However, that's not actually the case, and the opposite is 100% true. Many times in the original 522 chapters of the Dragon Ball manga, Super Saiyan is referred to as a state. So is base form, actually. Super Saiyan being called the Super Saiyan state, and base form being called the normal state. So if the words form and state are used interchangeably, then obviously this is a huge piece of evidence for Ultra Instinct being a form. Mind you, Ultra Instinct is also verbatim called a form as well in the anime, so this is actually just something that's stated ad nauseum. Going back to the manga, as I said I would earlier, there it does call Ultra Instinct a technique, as I said, but it also refers to it as a state, sometimes even on the same page. Referring to it as a transformation does make sense, as it visibly changes Goku's physical appearance, something we really haven't seen any technique do, except for the red aura and the inflated muscles given by the Kaioken. This really does seem to bolster the argument for Ultra Instinct being a form, but it doesn't necessarily seem to be a form exclusively, rather it is somehow both a technique and a transformation. Which does leave us with a question. Why is Ultra Instinct a form for Goku and not for Whis, or even an incomplete form like Omen for Beerus, in the manga that is? This question may seem strange, but Whis describes Ultra Instinct as a technique in Resurrection of F, as I've already said, and even implies he's using it at all times with the gag scene. He's not using a form all the time though, instead he's just trained his body to do something without needing any conscious thought. Then take Beerus in chapter 28 of the Dragon Ball Super manga, and he is using an imperfect form of Ultra Instinct, but doesn't change his physical appearance or transform in any way that we can see. This is made more confusing when you consider the fact that in the anime, Whis claims to only be assuming things about Goku's Ultra Instinct, meaning that it is different from anything he had expected from the technique and isn't even sure that the form is Ultra Instinct. It's only after Goku's movements begin that he starts to understand what's happening, which should show that this is a mixture of a transformation and technique, and it isn't the common approach for Ultra Instinct, at least to some degree. This leads us directly into my speculation of what Goku's Ultra Instinct actually is. Ultra Instinct seems to be both a form and a technique, but really the transformation is just a limit-breaking form. Let me explain. Goku's body was outside the physical requirement of Ultra Instinct, not just the mental ones. So, Goku's body, in key moments of desperation, then transformed him to a level beyond any current power he had in order to save him. It's a fight or flight response. This power is referred to as limit breaking multiple times, meaning it's obviously beyond any power he's previously had, and that this power is leading him to heights that may be beyond his ability to ever reach, at least on his own without breaking those limits. This transformation specifically gives him enough power and speed on a physical level to allow him to use Ultra Instinct. However, much like Super Saiyan 3, Goku accessing power that so far exceeds what he is really capable of has a far higher toll on his body and stamina than anyone could have expected. Each time Goku transformed into his limit-breaking form, he not only got stronger, but his movements under the effects of Ultra Instinct became sharper, implying that there is a correlation between Goku's strength and his ability to even use Ultra Instinct successfully and effectively. This makes quite a few things make more sense as well, like the form providing Goku massive strength in terms of raw power, but Ultra Instinct, the technique that is, causing the attacks that Goku performs to lose their power, as Whis even says that the technique dulls the power of attacks when thoughts are in the way. It makes more sense that Ultra Instinct is dulling Goku's transformation power rather than Ultra Instinct is dulling its own power. Finally, all this leads me to believe that Ultra Instinct is not a multiplier. What I mean by that is the limit-breaking form, by this theory, is the minimum amount of strength required to actually use Ultra Instinct. That minimum doesn't change, so this would be a static level of power until Goku's base exceeds that power and can use Ultra Instinct on its own, no limit-breaking form required from then on. If Ultra Instinct isn't a multiplier, then it makes even more sense with the interview I mentioned earlier that says it's completely different in terms of a power-up than Super Saiyan. This portion has just been my speculation though, so feel free to leave your thoughts in the comments down below.
Thanks for watching! Make sure to hit the like button, leave your opinions and counterpoints in the comments down below, and hit subscribe and the notification bell. That way you get to stay up to date on the channel and everything that goes on with it. If you're interested, please check out the merch store to support the channel in another way that gives you something in return. But till next time, peace!